Welcome, Administrator Guzman.
Thank you.
Wonderful to be with you. Thank you for joining us at the Opportunity Finance Network Conference. So we're here in an amazing entrepreneur's shop with history behind it.
That's right.
You know, three generations of Taylors. You also have a personal history as a daughter of a small business owner and an entrepreneur yourself. If you wouldn't mind just starting a little bit about your story, about what makes you interested in helping America's small businesses.
Yes, well, I mean, I think Mr. Lofton of J.C. Lofton's Tailor Shop actually said it well, where, you know, he learned from his grandfather how to talk to customers, how to be with customers. And I think at an early age, that was really impactful on me and my perspective of community, because everyone who walked in that door was special to my dad, and they knew my dad, and they loved and shared, you know, the service of the veterinary hospital together.
Your dad was
a veterinarian. That's right.
Oh,
and still practicing today.
Oh.
But he's, so that experience of, like, that love and, you know, mutual compassion and just respect, I thought was really, you know, so profound in a business setting. And so for me, I think that's really what I always carried through, is that strong relationship to the neighborhoods, the communities that these businesses are located in. I mean, they are part of our community. And we saw that in COVID, where so many people realized how important their small businesses were to them, because they saw them closing, even if it was temporarily, and that panic that, oh my gosh, that's my favorite restaurant, my favorite tailor, my favorite gym, whatever it was. And I think that's one of the reasons I love small businesses so much, because it gives you that, that grounding in community. And also because I saw it, you know, build wealth for my own family, and it does for so many. It's a strong pathway to, you know, creating wealth, generational wealth for families. And it's what put me through school. You know, entrepreneurship put me through school and created opportunity for me and my siblings. And so I think that's what's powerful about small business. And they are so important to our economy. And we know that they create so many jobs. They're 2/3 of net new jobs, and half the private workforce nearly are employed by small business owners. And that's really why they're giants in our economy. And I really, you know, I feel like it's my life mission to make them feel like that.
Yeah. I love that. Make the small businesses feel like the giants in the economy. So you came back to Washington for this administration.
Yes.
And you're really part of an agenda to build us back better. What's the SBA's part of that build back better mission?
Yeah, we're so critical for the economy because we support our small businesses. You know, we give them the capital to grow, the technical assistance and resources to connect to markets, and those networks to give them a team of support around them. And so the SBA is all about trying to build these businesses back, help them reopen, make sure that they can create jobs, retain their employees, and that they can grow more resilient into the future. And so we, you know, we feel that it's really important that we give them the tools, because we know that there are disparities and barriers to many businesses' success. Our smallest entities, our underserved businesses, women and people of color, rural, you know, entrepreneurs and veterans, women and people of color are starting businesses at such high rates, but just have limited opportunities to access capital or markets. And so their growth is diminished, and that affects our economy.
Do you feel people know this when you're out speaking? Do you feel people understand that it's women and people of color, we're sitting in a black-owned business right now, that are driving a lot of the growth? Is that a well-known?
I'm not so sure that that is. I mean, I think that, you know, it depends, I suppose, as well where you are. But just recognizing that massive impact that they're having on our economy, because, you know, they are the ones starting businesses. And so we need them to be able to have the skills to grow at the same levels of all their peers in order for our economy to recover. And so for me, Build Back Better is very intentional about that equity piece, about making sure that all of our businesses can grow, and just making sure that all of our businesses can grow.
Yeah. Let's talk a little bit about the future. We hope it will never have a pandemic again. But what did we learn from this chapter of small business contraction and then hopefully building back? You know, a lot of CDFIs were partners with the SBA in the Paycheck Protection Program. But what did we learn from that? What do you think will be some of the enduring lessons mm-hmm. for the SBA going mm-hmm. forward?
And I think there are, those are where the silver linings lay yeah. as well, because we knew, became more clear that it was about connection. You know, yes. who was connected to resources, who had knowledge of you know, that banker or that mission lender or, you know, the technical assistance provider, that local small business development center or women's business center or SCORE chapter. That's, those are the individuals who had that leg up, because we know statistically that they do better if they're layered with this support around them. And so connectivity and then collaboration, because we can't be separate in our, you know, all of us are focused on trying to right. support these small businesses, and we have to collaborate in order to really propel them forward. Yeah. So I think collaboration, that partnership has come out, and technology. So our small businesses have adopted it, and yeah. we've adopted yeah. it in order to better reach them at scale. And I think those will be transformative as we move yeah. forward.
I like the way you've referenced connectivity, mm-hmm. all of the connections, the collaboration, the technology. Those were things I think the CDFI field learned from this period too. When you started in this administration, you changed some things. You kind of put CDFIs to the front of the line when we were trying to provide PPP assistance. You know, what's the hope now for the future of working with CDFIs and mission lenders, MDIs? What is your hope going forward for our partnership?
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, I'm so proud to be part of an administration, the Biden-Harris administration, that really values equity and really is there to support the smallest entities, the underserved communities, underbanked, which is what you all do in the CDFI community. And I've worked for a long time with CDFIs, you know, helped the startup team around a CDFI bank, you know, worked in California extensively with CDFIs. And I know that you're fighting right alongside us, advocating for these businesses that really need the support to grow and know this marketplace more than anyone else. Like, you've worked yes. hand in hand with these entrepreneurs on the ground, learning their experiences, learning their fears, learning their challenges, and learning which products work and which don't.
There you go.
And where there are, you know, deficits and challenges. And so I think our partnership with CDFIs is critical if we're trying to make sure that we can better serve these communities from the federal government's perspective. And I think, you know, that you've had nearly 50 years of history of actually working with these businesses. And I think that's it's a great time to look towards the future and what we can do to grow and scale.
It's so important for us to hear out of our federal officials that you understand our past, that you understand our place in this economy, that you understand the way we tailor products, and that you understand that we want these partnerships. This agency that you lead has scaled way more than people thought. No
yes.
one thought $1 trillion could be flowed through the SBA.
Right.
And I think you look to partners for that. And, you know, no one thought that the CDFIs and MDIs could do $30 billion mm-hmm. of Paycheck Protection Program loans. And we found the partners to get that done. So I do want to end on a note of thinking about future work together. And I want you to know that this is a field that will be listening to you virtually as we speak, that wants this partnership, that wants to be strong partners, that wants to not be considered junior partners, but
right,
actual
right.
partners with you. What could we be doing more with you mm-hmm. to make those partnerships real?
Yeah, well, I mean, I thank the CDFI community, the whole CFIs as well, the, you know, MDIs and others, just that they've been so critical in helping us achieve our goals in the Biden-Harris administration. I mean, in 2021, 96% of the PPP loans went to smaller entities, 20 and under, with really strong results in low income and rural communities. We were able to really reach the more solopreneurs. And, you know, I know that that partnership was really important. So thank you for that, first and foremost. You know, I know that, you know, as we look to the future, as well. I mean, we want to make sure that we're designing programs and policies that really meet our businesses where they are. Yeah. That's really important to me. I've asked my team to be entrepreneurial and,
good.
You know, be customer first and technology forward and equitable in everything that we do. You know, as we're looking to the future to design capital programs that really make sense to filling some of those gaps for our small businesses, we know that we want all of our partners to join us in those initiatives. And you know, with the Build Back Better agenda and reconciliation, the Biden-Harris administration is doubling down on making sure that small businesses have a strong position in the future and in this administration, and that we're having a whole of government approach to building marketplaces for them. I mean, in the bipartisan infrastructure deal investments, as well as you know, just commitments around contracting, for example, and making sure that we can connect businesses to a contract, because the revenue side of the equation, I say, is always just as important as the capital. The capital is there to access those opportunities, so we need to connect them to those opportunities, connect them to the global markets that we know that we can thrive in, and you know, let them thrive in e-commerce as they've been doing, as they've pivoted and adapted during this time. And on the capital front, we want to make sure we can finally solve some of those small dollar loan challenges, you know, of $150,000 and under, and have a bigger role in the SBA to power our lenders and our networks and better connect with the 32.5 million small businesses and innovative startups. It's such a huge task. Yeah. So we're trying to be as innovative, transformative as possible, and you know, learn from lessons throughout COVID and pre-COVID to identify, you know, those flaws and fissures in the economy, as Vice President Harris has said, and make sure that we address them with smart solutions that have, you know, wraparound technology that powers our networks, our distribution networks. And I think, you know, as we look to the future, we just want to be that team for our partners, our CDFIs, as well as all the businesses, because we know that, you know, I've learned from a young age, you need a team and professionals around you that can really help you take business to the next level, and for us, take these programs to the next level to serve all of our businesses. So
great. Well, you speak like an entrepreneur who understands both the complexity and the joy of this. We want to be part of your team for the way we support our businesses and the way we support this country's growth. So please accept my big thanks for being with us today and helping us show how we can continue to finance justice and change in this country. Thank you so much, Administrator Guzman.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.